through a mirror darkly. And here the man who holds the glass is darker still. Let me show you. Caldecott, executed in the Ithian forests, just outside the capital city, put up a hell of a fight. In this reality, he's the reason you have that nifty synthetic body. General Martok, defeated in armed combat after a bioengineered virus, by all accounts a nasty little creation, decimated his Klingon homeworld. And Sarek. Director Sarek. Decapitated on the steps of the Vulcan Science Academy in front of a crowd that included his wife and son. Nice touch. And all carried out by the same withering hand. Who? Why, the greatest general the mighty Confederation of Earth has ever seen. The most bloodthirsty, merciless, ruthless human to ever set out to conquer the galaxy. You, of course.
What is this hellhole, Q?
This is the only life you understand. Shall we see what else has been lost in the wake of your fear? Now, you're welcome to remain here, in the body of a madman, in the world of a madman, and to attempt, like Macbeth, to wash the blood from your hands, but I assure you, Jean-Luc, it's unwashable. Or atonement. Maybe even forgiveness.
Forgiveness for what?
I think you know. But don't worry. I won't let you do this alone.
Whatever it is, I won't do it anyway. Q, I refuse.
I'm sorry. Do you wish me to respond to the designation Q, sir?
Forgive me, I can't remember your name.
Harvey, sir. Your valet?
Harvey, I suppose you didn't see the individual I was talking to just now.
No, sir. My sensors confirm no one has been here all morning. May I ask if you're all right, sir?
No. I don't know who I am. But I'm not myself.